Good morning, students. I am Sanghamitra. Today I am going to describe the fourth story from Footprints that named A Question of Trust, written by Victor Canning. Before going to describe this story, I am analyzing who was Victor Canning. Victor Canning was a prolific British writer of novels and thriller-related books he had written. He was born on 16th June in 1911 and was died on 21st February in 1986. He was flourished in the 1950s, 1960s and 1970s. He has written so many books, almost 61. Among his works, his writings, Mr. Finchley Discovers England, this is very most important, and The Runaway, that is also important among these. He was the son of taxi driver. That means by profession, his father was a taxi driver. His father's name was Fred Canning and his mother's name Mabel Nee Gold. He by profession, he was an anti-aircraft. So let us discuss the introduction, the story, that means summary and message. In this story, you will see total two major characters are there. First one, Horace Dunby, and second one, the lady in red. I am saying a few lines about these characters. So who was Horace Dunby? Horace Dunby was 50 years old and he was unmarried. Apparently, he was good, honest, but not completely honest. He had a hobby that was he used to buy rare and costly books, and instead of buying, he just used to and he used to rob a safe every year, and for using this money, he used to buy these rare and costly books. That is his hobby. And his character was a flat character. I have said what is flat character and round character. You have seen a round character, that is the character of Hari Singh in the Thief story. A round character is that has been changed from good character to bad character, from dishonest to honest. That is changed throughout the story. Hari Singh's character also changed from dishonest to honest by the help of another character, main character. I have just forgotten this name. You will see this story, the Thief story. And in this story, Horace Dunby's character, that has not been changed, that will not be changed. You can see this is called flat character. And another opposite character is there, the lady in red. That means the lady in red is gifted with a rare personality, and she is very intelligent. And at the end of the story, you will see Horace Dunby will be caught by the police by the intelligence of this lady. And let's see what is happened in this story. The whole story is narrated by Horace Dunby, the main character, that is called protagonist. This story is about a thief, Horace Dunby, who was a thief, who gets a taste of his own deeds. He used to steal money, jewelry, everything. Horace Dunby is a thief completely, but apparently everyone knows he was a very good, honest person. But he was not completely very good person. He was a thief by profession. He steals only once in a year. He is fond of books and spends most of his money on buying books. Also, he plans accurately before attempting any burglary. During his burglary attempt at a big house, he studied well before entering the house for stealing from the safe. A lady thief cheated on him, who claims herself to be the owner of the house. Finally, Horace Dunby ends up in prison only to regret the way that a man should not trust anyone, particularly from his own profession. You will get a moral from this story. It is also called a moralistic story. That which moral? Always be self-confident. No one trust on any unknown person blindly. Otherwise, you will be deceived by someone. That is the moral of this story. Let's see the summary of this story. Horace Dunby had a good reputation in the society. He was about 50 and unmarried. He made locks and had two helpers. He loved rare and expensive books. Horace robbed a safe every year. He was now out for committing a robbery. For 2 weeks, Horace had studied the house of Shotover Grange. He had to burgle this house. Horace Dunby entered the house. Horace had allergy from flower. It is called hay fever. He started sneezing. Then he heard a voice. The voice told him that he could cure the sneeze. It was the voice of a woman. She stood in the doorway. She was young and pretty. His first thought was to run. The lady told him that she would telephone the police. She would tell them about him. Horace Dunby told him to let him go and forget she ever saw him. The lady put one condition for letting Horace go. She told him that she had promised her husband to take her jewel to the bank. She had, however, left jewels in the safe. She told him that she wanted to wear the jewels in a party that night. She came down to get them, but she had forgotten the numbers to open the safe. So she needed his help, and Horace opened the safe for her. After 2 years, a policeman had arrested him for the jewel robbery at Shotover Grange. Dunby's fingerprints were found all over the room. He had opened the safe without gloves. He said to the police that the landlady of the house said him to open the safe. But the lady was a 60-year-old woman. She said Dunby's story is a nonsense. Horace is now in prison. He often thinks of the charming and clever young lady. She was in the same profession. She had simply tricked him. Tricked means deceived him. By telling a false story, she was not actually the owner of this house. She was by profession a thief. Same profession. Dunby gets angry when anyone talks about honor among thieves.